Welcome back, YouTube, to another session of Star Ocean.
Like kind of a tight fit.
Don't complain. If we can get through there, it widens out a bit. We'll just have to squeeze through that first part.
Yeah, yeah.
Fate, you go first. I'll bring up the rear.
Where are we?
We're in the aqueducts that wind their way under the city.
Aqueducts, huh? Hey, it's all frozen over.
This comes as a surprise to you? It is winter in Aeriglyph. Didn't you see the snow falling outside?
Good point.
Careful. You're no good to us if you fall in the water and freeze to death.
Scary.
Let's get moving. This way leads to the city if we can make it through.
Okay, so there's a health point there. Gives a chance to grind if necessary. Nothing of interest in there. Oh, remember this one's got some traps in it, maybe, or could be thinking about something else. I remember one section that had ice in it and there were traps. Well, not so much traps, but stuff put in there to catch her out. Whoops.
That's a dirty trick.
So that's how it's gonna be, huh? Yeah.
Blade of Fury! Blade of Fury! Blade of Fury! Blade of Fury! Blade of Fury!
I'd have preferred a more worthy opponent.
Now, thought I saw something there then. Oh, it's skeletons. Thank you. Oh, hang on. Looks like this way it is then. Fun little thing about this, if you actually try them, you have to be... Oh no, it's not that beat. Check so much like that. Oh, okay, yeah, all misunderstood some of you all remember, yeah. It's actually normal for a Starvation game to do with it, what I was thinking. Oh well.
Okay.
It's just a bit of a revival as well. What are you doing talking? You're dead. Oh. And that's what I'm talking about. Okay, what am I missing? Over to the right.
Nice to see the sun. I was down in that muck so long I thought I was gonna mildew.
Now, about what you were saying. You were talking about technology. But what exactly do you want us to do for you?
I'll explain, but remember, refusal isn't an option. You in the dungeons that I required your technology, did I not?
Right, but what does that entail?
Look, if this was going to be a problem, you should have asked me before you accepted my conditions. By agreeing to cooperate, even just to get out of the dungeon, you're bonded to me. Those were the conditions of your release, and I expect you to uphold them.
But...
Or are you planning on breaking your word?
Look, you didn't even give us a real choice. You can live or you can die. That's called coercion, you know.
So you won't cooperate?
When did I say that? What do you say? Let's help her out.
What are you talking about? What about the UP3?
This is hardly the time or the place, kid.
That may be, but still...
Excuse me. Can we save the discussion for later? We're not exactly safe here. Of course, if you want to head back to the dungeon, be my guest.
No thanks.
All right, then be quiet and follow. I'll tell you everything when we get out of town. Good. My people have a wagon waiting for us outside town. The exit's to the east. Let's go.
I was not paying attention then. I didn't need to do that, did I? Oh, never mind. I think my ADHD has actually screwed me over somewhat. Oh, maybe not.
Sorry I'm late.
Lady Nell! Our preparations are complete, ma'am. We can leave immediately.
Nice work, Tiny.
I'm just glad you're safe. Lady Nell! Are these the ones, ma'am?
Yes, Farlene. They're engineers from Greeton, as we thought.
So we were right.
Great! Then we'll be able to complete it!
That's right. But we don't have time to kick back and chat now. Our pursuers are right behind us. If the Dragon Brigade shows up, we'll be in serious trouble.
Yes, ma'am.
Get in the wagon. We leave immediately.
Introduce me to these fine young ladies.
This is Tynave, and the driver's Farlene. They serve directly under me, my ears and eyes in Aeriglyph. They're the ones who told me about you two.
Lucky for us.
All women, huh? Not that I'm complaining.
Aquaria is ruled by the Holy Mother of the Church of Abrus. We employ many more women than Aeriglyph.
Church of Apris?
Yes, the Church of the Sun God Apris. The Holy Mother leads the church, and is also Queen of Aquaria.
A theocracy.
I gotcha. What you're saying is your country's packed with temple maidens. Now I have to see this place.
It's just a horn dog, isn't it?
You'd answer my question now.
Right. But before that, might I ask one thing?
What?
Are you two really engineers from Greeton?
Well,
Hey, you still don't believe us?
It's not that. It's just, the fact that you possess special technology and knowledge is clear to me. So yes, it does seem likely that you are who you say. Still, something doesn't fit. The way you respond to danger and your fighting ability indicate that you are not telling me everything. And you are certainly not average engineers. So you see, I believe my doubts are well-founded.
Well...
Okay, you got a point. But it seems to me you're just gonna have to take our word. We got nothing to gain by lying to you anyway. Wait. You don't think we're Aeriglyph spies, do you? Oh, please.
Yes, I see what you mean.
But you still don't trust us.
No, I trust you. In any case, I was ordered by Her Majesty to bring you to Aquaria. I must fulfill my duty.
Well then, Mel, please answer my first question.
Yes, since you're unfamiliar with this region, I'll fill you in on the details while explaining our current situation.
Please.
Tiny, the map.
Yes, ma'am.
This is Aeriglyph, the town we just left. Everything to the west of this line is the nation of Areglyph, a military superpower. Eastwards of the border is our country, Aquaria. You follow? As I mentioned earlier, Aquaria and Areglyph are at war. Areglyph is a militaristic nation that reveres power above all else. Aquaria is a peaceful nation that worships the Church of Apris. Aquaria and Areglyph maintained friendly relations until several years ago. But one day, they invaded our territory without warning.
It seems they've been planning their invasion for some time. Areglyph's a frigid land ringed by mountains. Food production has never been easy here, especially in winter. We believe they were after our land, fertile with the blessing of Apris.
A war of aggression, huh?
Correct. There was no diplomacy, only outright military aggression. We resisted, but we were outmatched. Somehow we managed to hold them back, but the border town of Arius was laid to waste. Still, the war has not been completely one-sided. We may be lacking in military power, but we do have runology.
Runology?
A secret art handed down by the followers of Apris. We inscribe special runes into our flesh that enable us to invoke normally impossible phenomena. Thus the name Runology.
So that's how you broke the prison bars.
Correct.
Special runes? They look like tattoos. I can't help feeling I've seen something like this before.
I would sigh.
Isn't that like symbology?
Symbology. Right. That's what it reminded me of.
Yeah.
Symbology?
Never mind that. Just continue.
But what's stopping you from using runology to keep Areglyph back?
There are only a few of us that can use runology. Far too few to help us stand up to Areglyph. That's why we decided to develop a weapon that makes use of runology. It's a man-made weapon that uses the special energy evoked by runology as a power source. The engineers have named that energy Channeled Force.
Channeled Force?
Correct. It's similar to lightning, but there are still a number of problems preventing us from completing the weapon.
A power similar to lightning?
Just when our research ground to a halt, Tynave and Farlene told me about you two. They also brought back a fragment of that thing that fell into Areglyph. It was of great interest to our researchers. They said the fragment was of a material they could not identify, and that we should enlist your aid in our weapons development. And that's where I came in.
So you're asking us to help develop a weapon that uses channeled force?
Yes, that is correct.
Their power to make us a communicator.
Yeah, a radio wave device, maybe. I don't really know much about this channeled force, but my guess is it's electricity. And if we can make that, we're home free. But, Nell, I can't do it. We can't help you.
Didn't I say refusal wasn't an option?
But you're talking about a weapon that will kill many people. I don't want to have any part of that. Plus, we don't have any time to spare.
I understand your situation. You need to hurry to save your father, correct?
Yes.
You admit this is a personal problem, not one that concerns us.
True, but...
Our country is in a state of war. Both the people of Aquaria and Areglyph are dying, energy weapon or no. A quick end to this war will reduce the number of lives lost. That is why we need to complete our new weapon as soon as possible.
This is starting to remind me of my old Earth history lessons.
Even so, that's not a good enough reason for me to build a weapon.
So you're going back on your word?
That's coercion.
Call it what you will. I already told you back at the prison I could not let you live if you refused to cooperate. I don't have anything against you two, but my duty comes first. And I don't need to remind you that you can't help your father if you're dead.
Now, wait a second.
What do you think Aeriglyph would do if we abandoned you here?
We wouldn't help them either.
I wonder if you'd sing the same song after their Inquisitioner had his fun with you.
I would. I've already had a taste of it, believe me.
Confident, aren't you?
Hey, don't get all bent out of shape. And you, chill out.
But...
No buts, kid. Nothing good comes of acting hastily.
We have no other choice. Frankly, the war with Aeriglyph will escalate unless something is done soon. If we could only complete the new weapon, the situation would shift in our favor. If that means we must force uncooperative people into submission, then so be it.
Is that a teaching of Apris?
Of course not. The sun god Apris and our queen would never wish such things. Yet if we do not act, they will find themselves lacking for followers. Would you rather we submit to their swords like lambs to a slaughter?
That's not what I mean.
But that is what you are saying.
You're just twisting my...
What is it, Farlene?
We have company! I think it's the Dragon Brigade!
They've caught up with us? Damn!
Why did they not pop into the shop? How are you, idiot?
What are you gonna do? Fight?
Lady Nell.
What is it, Tynave?
It would be best for you to slip off and find shelter in the rocks. We'll lure them away.
That's too risky!
Don't worry.
We'll be fine. We've lost their kind before.
But...
Tynave, Farlene, I'm counting on you. Okay, you two, let's go.
This is insane. You're just gonna let them go on?
You are too valuable for us to lose. We'll be fine. Fewer people means more speed. We'll outrun them. So please, go!
No time for chit-chat. Let's move!
But...
Fate... Please, look after Lady Nell.
You be careful yourself.
Yeah, I know how to talk to him, don't I?
Dragon Brigade. I fear they'll show up sooner or later. It shows how important you are to them.
That's the Dragon Brigade?
Correct. They're one of Aeriglyph's three military branches. Knights riding powerful air dragons. Not to be trifled with. Time to go. While Tynave distracts them, we can go through Kurlsaw and enter Aquaria territory.
Wait a moment! I haven't agreed to cooperate with you yet. And we can't leave them here. There's no way they'll be able to escape with those dragon knights chasing them.
Yes. There's an extremely good chance that they'll be caught. But there's nothing we can do about them.
What?
They knew the dangers of their mission and they accepted it. If I became a burden to the mission, they would leave me behind in the same way.
Mission? Mission? What's the matter with you?
He's not a military kid, is he?
But...
I'll leave whether or not we cooperate up to you. But save the debate for later. We gotta get somewhere safer first. We'll be safer once we reach Aquaria, right?
Yes. I can guarantee that.
There you are. So let's go there, then we can decide what's what. Make sense to you?
Yeah, but still.
You want Tynave and Farlene's sacrifice to go to waste? Whatever their objective might be, they're risking their lives to save us.
You're right.
Adam.
Let's go.
What's wrong?
My head.
Are you sure you're all right?
I just felt dizzy there for a minute.
We'll be in Curlsaw soon. Can you make it that far? Why don't you have him carry you?
I'm fine. I'm not a baby, jeez.
Teenagers.
This is Curlsaw. If we can get through this town, we'll be in Aquaria. Are you all right?
I'm fine.
Don't overexert yourself. Remember, you're not as strong as we are.
Now even you're treating me like a baby. I said I'm fine.
Yeah, well, I'm saying you don't look fine at all.
I'd prefer to just leave this town now, but that won't be possible with Fate in this condition. Let's stay here tonight.
What about those guys chasing us?
We'll be okay if Tynave and Farlene succeed in leading them off. And in any case, we have nothing to gain by forcing a sick person to march.
True enough.
And we're in luck. There's an inn right over there in that building with a wagon outside. Let's go. I'll see you later.
Where are you going?
I'm just going to check things out. I'll be right back.
All right, but are you sure you should leave us alone? Aren't you afraid we'll just run away?
No, you won't run out on me. I trust you, remember?
Don't say that. Now we can't run away.
I don't mind you walking around. Just don't leave the town. And don't do anything conspicuous. We're still in Aeriglyph territory. There's no telling where the enemy is hiding.
Gotcha.
All right.
Later then.
Yeah, there is a... I think there's a side story in this town, actually.
Don't worry about me. What are you gonna do?
I'm conspicuous just walking around. Well, it's gonna be pretty boring. I guess I'll just have to wait right here.
I think I'll take a walk. I'm sure it'll do me good.
All right, but be careful. Like she said, we're still in enemy territory.
Yeah, I know.
About a save point anywhere? There we go. Okay, and I think I'm actually going to end this stream right here. It's a good spot, I think. So, If you're watching on YouTube, thank you very much, really do appreciate it. If you enjoyed it, click the like on the video and subscribe to my channel and you'll get notified if you enjoy these sort of stuff. And even better, pop on over to Twitch and you can follow me on there. I really would appreciate that a lot more, to be honest. And if you're watching on Twitch and you haven't clicked follow yet, please click follow and you will get more stuff like this. The more followers I get, the more motivated I'll do to do streams on a more regular basis. But for now, I'm doing what I can despite my health issues. But anyway, thank you guys, thank you very much, I do appreciate it, and I'll see you.